You know, I just realized that using wind power, we're actually in this whole quest line here. Going from like this to this was actually kind of pointless. Of course, if you don't want to use lava power, that's totally fine. You can just make a bunch of these things, these improved windmills, but I'm not really interested in using power from reverse engineering. Well, at least wind power, at least. I don't know what other methods of power there are in immerse engineering. Alright. So anyways, hello everybody, my name is Dude Man, and welcome back to some more space astronomy. I was about to say simply magic, because I had that on my mind right at the moment. So, I think we should finally get into lava power generation. I think. I don't know, I'm thinking, like, why did I do the whole wind thing? Oh, yeah, sorry, I was pissed. I'm sorry, I was like, I'm thinking, like, how am I gonna transfer power? It makes no sense. Thinking, like, well, I have a lot of lava generator, and I have enough resources to make an ender tank. So I was like, yeah, there you go. Okay, let's remove that. Really, this thing does have a limit to the height. If you get it too high, it won't generate power for some reason, even though it's moving. I don't know, it's kind of weird. Okay, put that down. Here, let's finally make the tank. As you can see, I put auto repair on most of my tools here. Pretty nice. Okay, so I think the modifier is cool. Okay. We have all the items, we can just simply do this. Nice. Now we need to make the quarry. Wait, hold on. Not the quarry, the pump! Why did I... I was thinking of something else. Oh my goodness. There's just so many ways to make gears, it's just confusing me. I can make it that way now? I can make it this way now? What the hell is going on? Okay. It's like confusing the crap out of me. Okay, here we go. Alright, now we got our pump. It seems like it wants us to make another lava generator. So, gonna get a block of iron, 5 gold, 2 redstone, and a furnace. I am now getting that achievement, but okay. And there we go. Now we pretty much completed the quest. I'm gonna get a... Oh! I keep forgetting! It just says you're getting this instead of pick a reward. Oh my god, I cannot read apparently. Okay. Oh man, this is gonna be really great. I have a lot of lava generating. Wow. Of course, we're gonna need one to power the pump, so make sure for that. What the heck? Oh, never mind. It was the farm. There we go. That's better. All right, let's head to the Nether and make a little place for this thing. Oh god. I forgot, I actually need a chunk loader. Yeah, I need a chunk loader. Oh god, why? Bunch of danger spots that can catch me on fire. It's a plane. Lava. I definitely stepped on that. What the heck was that? Alright. I think this would be a good place. Come on. I keep going into my inventory for some reason. Okay. Alright. Let's just make a little. Actually, no, it doesn't matter how we do this. There we go. Definitely need power. Okay, we got. Ugh. Nope, can't have it there, actually. Excuse me. There we go. Place it there, I guess. What am I doing? I forgot my fluid. Ugh, be right back. Okay. I got enough obsidian, got two books and two diamonds and a couple ender pearls. This took frickin' forever and I forgot the goal! Dang it! There we go, sweet. Okay, two chunk loaders, ready to go. Place it right there. I can just simply leave it alone now. Doesn't need to be any... I don't think it needs to be increased at all. Alright, there we go. And we can place our chunk loader there. Need to load any more chunks as it is. It's good to go. Okay. Let's turn that on. I just simply need to put lava in here. And it should start working. There we go. Now it's collecting lava. First, it needs to gather some from the tank here, clearly. Look at that, it's gathering some more lava. When this thing starts working, it sends a pipe downwards. And that's what it was doing the whole time, that's why it was like stalling a little bit. And there you go. We got lava, and we can get this from the nether while we're in the nether, or the overworld, I almost said the nether world. And this is all what we need. I mean, it's able to keep up insanely fast in the buffer. It can hold about 16 millibuckets of lava. So, again, really nice. I love this. I don't know why that's happening, but okay. In the future, I might end up upgrading to the endothermic bomb. Because, oh my god, nether music's so creepy. Because, well, it's a hell of a lot better than the BC pump, and it has its own chunk loader too, so that's also very nice. And I think I can even, like, reach out even farther than the pump can, maybe. I don't know. But we got that going. Let's just sleep real quick. Alright, now we can simply just get to our tank here. Might add an extra one. Because, you know, it just looks kind of awkward. Hey, creeper! I think we can turn this around, right? There we go, cool. Oops, actually, that's a little bit too low. There we go. Getting lava. Put a lot of it, and it should be making power. And it is, and we're getting a whole lot! Nice! This thing can transfer about 9600 RF per tick. We're definitely making a lot more power than we did with the windmill, definitely. Which is nice. Okay, drop some lapis pants, I think that's what it was. And there we go, we have made an efficient way of, a lot better way of making power than we did previously, which is nice. And I really can't hear myself right now, because a lot of things are way too loud. Is there such thing as a sound muffler? Thank God. Why am I hearing things explode? Oh, don't tell me. It was those pipes. Damn it. Okay, that's actually new to me. I did not know these things would explode. Oh, what? Oh my god, I can't believe I made that mistake. I was using the wrong type of fucking pipes. Oh my god. Really? Oh my god. You can just tell how out of touch I am with tech right now, honestly. I've never made that mistake before. I hate how thermal expansion split itself up into two or three or four mod packs or mods. Fucking mods. Ugh. I need hardened fluid ducts which can handle cold and hot, which is pretty much, well, lava, invar, and lead. I'm guessing, yeah, the ones in the nether, well, I guess the one pipe in the nether might have exploded too, so that's also nice. I cannot believe I made that mistake. You guys that have been playing way more tech than I have, if you have, you're probably fucking laughing at me right now. And rightfully so. Holy crap. Jeez. Alright, let me go replace that pipe in the nether. Oh my god. I thought it was like creepers randomly exploding and think, what the hell is going on? But no, it was the pipes exploding. I've never made that mistake ever in my life. I guess I was a little bit too excited to get lava power, or get power from lava. Jeez. Well, at least it's not as bad as what happened with the whole Microsoft conference of Minecraft. Oh my god, that was so cringy, and yes, it did explode, look at that. I've never seen such a cringy, what's the word? I've never seen a conference so cringy for a certain game or whatever you call it, ever in my life. That was the worst thing I've ever seen ever. If you've seen the conference for Microsoft, Xbox One, when you get, if you've seen that Minecraft part, you would know what I mean. Jesus, it was so bad. It was so bad. The freaking friendly update, I didn't understand. They didn't show how friendly it was. I mean, the whole video on the forums did, I guess. I mean, all it did is that, like, some guy needed to, or some guy stole the cookie from another player, and that player flipped a switch, and then it just activated a minecart railway roller coaster type deal. The player was really loud. God dang, I hit my mic. And then, oh my god, like the entire time this person's going on a railroad track roller coaster thing, and at the end he gets a cookie at the end. It's like, what? What the hell was the point of all that? The only thing, the point of it was, is just showing all the new things were in the friendly update. I really don't understand how that describes friendliness at all. It's like, the least friendly thing that I saw in there was that guy stealing that cookie from that girl player. That was the only thing that I saw that was unfriendly, I guess you could say. That made no sense, by the way. But the best part was, of that video, was that you're able to push chests with pistons. There's a part in the whole railroad track scene, whatever, that you can see pistons moving chests. That, well, one thing we can't do in vanilla Minecraft for, I guess, normal Minecraft and PC, not the Windows 10 bullshit edition. But, yeah, probably you can do that there, but not in vanilla. It's like, what? Oh, god. I don't know. That was like the best part of that update, in my opinion, honestly. So, I don't know. Again, that was just like the cringiest thing I've ever seen in my life of how they represented or showed off the friendly update. It was so weird. Okay, yeah, it's not getting any power, clearly. Which is weird. Why aren't you getting power? Oh, that would explain it. I didn't reconnect the power. Shoot. Oh, that was a blitz. I'm thinking, like, what is that crackling sound? Really close, too. I can't hear myself. Honestly, because... I don't know what they're showing. They're showing, like, a bunch of redstone circuitry contraptions and benches and stuff. You see a bunch of pistons moving redstone blocks. Like, we have never seen that before, I guess. What? I was like... Everybody was like, what the f- is this? Like, what is this? What is going on in your world, honestly? Everybody was asking that, like, what is this? Like, I'm... Oh, Jesus. And the two people that were showing off the video or the update on stage... That one guy, I swear to God, when he got on the stage, he was like looking like he was. This is what he was doing. Like I'm just gonna show it right now. And like, so he's on the stage, he's going like looking around like what? He's like looking all over the place, like he's lost or something, or he's scared. I don't know. He was looking all over the place. It was so funny. And then that girl, jeez, she pretty much made it all worse because of how cringy she acted. Oh my god. So bad. It was so bad. Oh my god. I had to look back on it, that was so funny. Okay, why don't we get back to what we're doing here. Alright. Can figure out what else we should do here, actually. We didn't really do much for today, honestly. The only thing we've done was actually get lava power, which is giving us a lot of it. A lot more than we did with the windmill. I think we should probably move on to the quarry. Get a landmark, too. Because, well, gotta do something else here. I'm gonna make 4 landmarks here. We just require redstone torches. There we go. That quarry. There we go. Oh, cool. We get some iron chests. Getting resources. Why are you telling me to get these? Weird. So, yeah. I'm gonna have to make another lava generator. Another ender tank. And... Oh, boy. Do we have trash cans? We should. I think it's from extra utils, maybe? Yes, it is. Okay. Oof. That's a very useful item to have. Make that real quick. So yeah, I'm gonna have to get a trash can. This is gonna be useful for the items that we don't need, which is gonna be cobble, dirt, gravel, sand, some other random ones. But of course we're gonna need it for a quest. Because we're here getting resources. We need like 1500 cobble, 500 dirt, and 2500 gravel. So that's the thing. Let's see. But yeah, that's what we have to do there. So yes, we need the lava generator, ender tank, some chests. I don't have any resources left to make a diamond chest. I wish Jabba was in here. I don't know why it's not. Wait, I can actually make a barrel from thermal expansion, actually. They have their own barrels, yeah, right here. They have a lot of room. Look at that, jeez. They're not that expensive, thankfully, except I do need to get more Envar. Yeah, I would make a tesseract, but I really don't have any enderpearls at the moment, so... Yeah, that's the problem. So yeah, alright, so I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna get these things real quick, and we're gonna go look for a place to set up our quarry. So yeah. And as usual, I forget to grab my fluid ducts. There we go. Alright, a picture spot. This is not that far away, but it's when you're making a quarry, you kind of want to have it really far away. That's not what I wanted. Forgot it does that when you place it down. Of course, if you don't want to do any landmarks, you just want to have like a simple chunk, you can do that, so. Okay, this is, that was embarrassing, actually. Let's click out of that. I wish that would stop appearing. But, yeah. I was trying to look for that one feature in, what's it? In this feature, you're able to see chunk borders and stuff. I can't figure out what, how to find that. But I ended up, oh, that was a snapshot. I ended up pressing my, god dang it! I ended up pressing my record button and it stopped. Of course, I ended up, one of my friends on, what's the game called again? Wow. Rainbow Six Siege ended up inviting me to ask if I could play. Say, like, you know, why not? I'm not really, how do I get back? Ah, okay, there we go. I mean, like, I just stopped recording on accident. So, I was like, you know, just give my computer a break or something. I don't know. I don't want to game to point. Why did I do that? So, let's see. So, yes, we were trying to set up a quarry before I derped with the recording. As you can see, my shovel repaired itself completely. It used to be way lower than it. Way, like, almost broken, pretty much. But now it's been repaired. Okay, so, let's see, did we have everything that I needed? I have a lot of food for some reason. I don't know why. I decided to get food on the way here. You can get the hell out of my inventory. So, we have a quarry, landmarks, ender tank, lava generators, okay. We have transfer nodes. I have no idea why I have that with me. Trash can, some chests, and some hardened fluid ducts, and some normal... What the heck? Chunks, load! Load! Oh my god! Thank god, they're loading. Jeez. Alright. So what we're going to do, we're going to get to our landmarks here. Place one right there. We're going to try and make a, pretty much a square. This does have a range, or has a limit to it. I think I might just have it right here. So I want a big quarry so we can get a lot of resources. Is this a block down? Yeah. Let me sleep real quick here. There we go. Okay, you can right-click it. If you're not sure if it's like on the same level or same block, whatever, the same, just right-click the landmark, okay? pretty much, that should be about it. I don't think you need a fourth one, to be honest. Because it would just get the other corner. Oh, I guess I was wrong. Never mind. Alright, let's just get this one going then. I'm going ahead of myself. There we go. It can also go through blocks too. So we're going to get some food in the quarry. So let's get rid of this. Oh, holy crap. Okay, it was killing itself. Alright. What's that called? Paper bark wood? Okay. So let's see. We can pretty much put our quarry anywhere we want on this red strip. And when we place it, it will end up leaving a, something else. I forgot what it's called. There we go. It'll be leaving these markers here, these tape. And now everything... what the fuck? Okay. Alright. It was weird. Like, that thing moved from the corner about a couple blocks to the left. I'm thinking, like, what the heck? How did you move? You were still placed. Oh, this game is freaking me out, guys! Okay, so... got my landmarks. They pop off once you place down your quarry. This thing needs quite a bit of power. More power than the... than the Then the pump. I don't know why I couldn't think of it. I was just having a blank on my mind. There we go. Sweet. Alright. Hardened fluid ducts. This will work. You can simply do that. There we go. Now we can get this started, but first... Oh boy. I really wish there was barrels, man! I really wish there was barrels, because this is going to mine pretty damn fast. Okay. Oh shoot, I forgot one thing. I need... Oh, thank god you loaded this time. I need friggin' servos, there we go, for thermal expansion, so I can route where these things go. I like the Java barrels better, though. I don't like the barrels from here, because it's expensive, though. Or from the thermal expansion, is what I mean. They're kind of expensive, which I kind of hate. So, okay, so we can, oh, whoops. Ah, wrong one! They look so similar! There we go. I don't think they can, like, output from the front. Let's do that. Or not. What the heck? Okay, why don't we get this started now? Because right now Yep, there we go. It needs to make the frames, I guess. And, god, this is so cool what it does. It's actually spewing out... Looks like wool. Maybe, I don't know. What's it doing? It also breaks blocks if it's inside of these tapes. This tape here. And plus it's starting to level out the... Here, let me sleep here. But it's trying to level out the whole place here so it's smooth and just, you know, nothing's in the way. Which is kind of weird, actually. But yeah, god, this is so cool. They used to do this back then. Now it's spewing out the frames, that's cool. It used to do this back then, but they ended up placing it with little robot coming by and destroying the blocks and placing the frames. But I'm glad they brought it back, because this is really cool. Here, let me... I forgot to turn the music back on. God, this is so freaking cool! There we go, now it's starting. Can we hook it up? No, we can't. Then where can we hook up this thing here? Yeah, see, it's spewing them out! What the heck? Does it have to be a chest right next to it? Yes, it does! Why was that stupid? Okay. That's really dumb, because I can't put a freaking... Oh my god, really? I'm missing something. Whatever, I can simply just route it with another freaking thing here, I guess. I don't understand why I have to do that, though. I've always been able to put, like, a little item duct next to it, and it worked just fine, but... For some reason, it's not working this time. I'm not sure. Okay, well, since this is working, why don't we finally get this thing routed? So I'm gonna have a trash can here, and this shouldn't take out items at all until it has a servo. Or as long as it's on, too. Now, when we have a hardened servo, we get more options and more space here, the blacklist or whitelist items, and we can do more stack sizes here, I guess. Stack sizes, okay. I guess like 16 amount of items could be extracted and stuff. So we're gonna have whitelist. Use metadata. I'm guessing like if there's tools that are going through the pipe, it can use whatever durability. I think when you take that off, I guess it will ignore that. I forgot what metadata means. You can correct me on that whole thing. But yeah, that's the thing. Okay, so I'm. At the moment, I can't get rid of dirt. That's the thing, because There's a quest where I need a certain amount of dirt. The quest delivery system. I can have items. Wait, can items route? Can I have a pipe? Do that? Yes, I can! Awesome. So I can have a servo routing a certain amount of items into this quest delivery system. The thing is, I need to know if I can. Okay, good. I can select task and do that. Alright, that's not what I was particularly looking for, but whatever, that's okay. We can get rid of that. I need to find stone. Give me stone, not frickin' marble, please. Thank you. Okay. It's funny, if you place a block above, it will just rush right to it, I think. No, I guess it doesn't. But it will get it. Okay. So, let's see. Place cobble. Oh, I had cobble with me the whole time. God dang it. Arg. Okay. Let me go get some gravel. I should have some gravel around here. At least the sounds of the lava generators aren't annoying. It's just like hums and stuff. Okay, now it's on. First, let me quickly select the task like I always freaking forget to do. And there we go. Items are going in here. We should be getting... Yep, there we go. It's increasing. Awesome! Okay, so that eliminates that quest right there. We just gotta wait until we all pretty much complete it. Ah, we see some copper! Look at that. That's awesome. I'm gonna get rid of some of these grass here so we can quick get so many damn seeds in the chests and stuff. I wonder what's gonna happen when that happens. Okay. I also forgot to mention, when you're using a quarry, make sure you have some water flowing around in your quarry area thingy. Because you will, without a doubt, encounter lava, and when that happens, you're gonna have a nightmare of a time trying to get rid of lava because, well, it's gonna run into lava lakes, and the quarry cannot mine through that. It can mine through water, but it can't mine through lava. So trying to get rid of all the lava is a pain in the ass, and I had to do that one time because, I don't know, I had to do that one time because I wasn't paying attention, apparently. So make sure you have water flowing in your quarry. I have no idea how big of a problem I'm going to have with this here. So I'm just going to get rid of it for now, and I'm going to run into more of it later down the road, because there's some that even spawns underground. I even found some like in a ravine at one time, so I'm going to get rid of this. Thankfully, it's just one block. Honestly, I think that may be about it for today, guys. In the next episode, we're going to come back to this quarry when it's, I would say, halfway through. I'm gonna probably AFK here for some time. Cool. So yeah, I'm gonna AFK here so I can, you know, have this guy mine. Cause I think it's too far away when I'm at my house, so I probably might not be able to chunk load. So, and then also in the next episode, we will. What do we do? I think we should try and make a tree farm too. Because we're in need of some wood, clearly. So yeah, it'll be pretty cool. I hate the fact that there's no Steve carts in here. That really sucks, honestly, because Steve carts is certainly fun to use and stuff, so. Alright, it's a pretty cool process. So anyways, guys. And we got an egg. Yeah, he'll pick up eggs. He'll pick up anything that's inside the quarry, which sucks. And I'm guessing that one made a chicken. Wow, that's weird RNG. This is a pretty cool system. I love it. Alright, so anyways, guys. I think that's it for today. If you want to try out this mod pack out for yourself, I'll have the link in the description below for you guys to download the FTB launcher. This is called Space Astronomy. And we're gonna be going into space soon. I don't know when though, but we'll get there someday. And stuff. So, anyways, guys, my name is Dude Man. I'll see you guys later. Boring.